better hit that subscribe button.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, on the internet and YouTube? I'm Freddy Fuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, MultiPlatGameTrap.com, the people's voice, and your favorite average gamer. I'm here to bring you some good deals that I had the attention drawn to me by Storm Ninja 4. And it has to do with Best Buy they have their own gaming magazine. And inside the gaming magazine costs $4.99. Inside the gaming magazine, you have a two coupons for two games. And I believe it's Batman Arkham Asylum is $20 off. The game in the store costs $29.99. So you ended up getting it for $10 and brand new. Mass Effect 2, which is $19.99 at the store, is $15 off, which ends up being $5. If you haven't picked up those games and you've been looking to pick them up for real cheap, there you go. Then they have a $15 coupon off of Final Fantasy 13 2. Bulletstorm is $15 and Rage is $15. Pre-owned games above $20 is $10 off. So half the value or whatever. Anyways, that was just something that was brought to my attention. So I thought I'd share that news with you. I'm actually probably gonna go pick up Mass Effect 2 for the PS3, then pick up Mass Effect 3 for the PS3. I didn't get into the first one, so I know the one for the PS3 comes with like some stuff that you get to do with interactive, basically comic book or whatever, and you get to make a whole bunch of decisions, and it affects the outcome of the game when it starts. So and you get all the backstory of the game. And everything like that. I will be picking up a memory card for my PlayStation Vita, so I can change accounts and do a Gravity Rush, Gravity Days demo overview, and talk about that game. That game looks very interesting. Just caught my attention. It's just something unique, and it looks really nice. It actually looks like a PS3 game. Or an Xbox 360 or a PC game. It looks nice. It looks very nice. And the gameplay on it looks solid. Get to control gravity and then do like, you know, aerial battle maneuvers. And you got this just weird. It's nice and weird. If you haven't seen any videos on it, just go onto YouTube, put Gravity Rush, and you'll see some videos pop up on there. Anyways, I want to just say one thing about a company that I got, and I usually get my electronic warranties for. It's called SquareTrade.com. And I got a warranty for a Samsung TV that I have, my 3D Samsung TV. And basically, it took a crap on me. It started getting like black snow in the screen and stuff like that. And, you know, plasmas look so good that you can tell any imperfection on the screen. So I had the problem with the TV I had before that, which was another Samsung plasma TV. This TV that I'm going to get next is probably going to be a LED TV, so I won't have to worry about the issues. But they came to fix it. It wasn't able to get fixed, and unlike most warranties, they guarantee the price of whatever you paid for it on the ticket, on your receipt. So awesome, you know what I'm saying? They ain't give me no hassles, no nothing about anything. Made my experience with them the best experience ever when it comes to warranties. And I've had my warranty from the TV that replaced was broken. It was from Best Buy, and you can see my video. I put a video up on there. Best Buy is their fucking warranties suck a dick, bowl of dicks, and Geek Squad could suck the bowl of dicks with them. Very rude motherfuckers when they come to your house and trying to rip you off. But I just wanted to let y'all know I've had a very good experience with them. I've always had, after dealing with Best Buy's warranty and being treated like shit, and then they trying to shaft me, and I ended up fucking making them bite the bullet on it because I'm a hard ass, and I just don't take shit from companies. I see corporations and companies as terrorists, and That's how I treat them. Anyways, great experience, great thing. Got my, you know what I'm saying, got the full refund of the TV. You know what I'm saying? And just a great experience. I I just want to throw that out there. You know what I'm saying? You go to Squaretrade.com and get discounts. You can actually Google like Squaretrade discount codes, and then you can find another 30% discount with a discount code or whatever, and put it in there, and end up being cheaper than what you would pay at like Best Buy or wherever, you know, Walmart, Target, and wherever you're getting your electronics from. You can buy the TV wherever the hell, or the electronic wherever the hell you want to, and then, you know, use that. Anyways, I just plugged that in there because I had a good experience, and I believe it's customer service is consumer worthy, and it's the way they do business is consumer worthy. So there you go, man. Square Trade, that's a shout out to y'all. Plugged y'all on my channel. Anyways, what games have y'all been playing? I got Sly Cooper, some Devious Raccoonus, which is the HD remake on, I got it free on PlayStation Plus. They gave me that free this month. And Super Street Fighter 2 HD Remix, they gave me that free this month. And they let you download that game Journey a week before it comes out or something like that. I don't know what's the time frame for it. But they let you download that early. Everybody knows I put the MotorStorm RC game that was on the PlayStation Vita. You can download it onto your PS3, the PlayStation Vita version of it, and it's free, you know what I'm saying? And you don't have to download it from your Vita. You can actually download that, hook it up via USB cable and transfer it from the PS3 to your Vita. And they give you another like a free car. It's like a little RC car with a birthday cake on it. That's free. On gaming news, I'm waiting for the games that I'm most ready to get are, what is it? Tom Clancy? Yeah, it says Future Soldier. It's I can't even remember the name. Anyways, it's Ghost Recon Future Soldier, and that game looks awesome. That game is it's gonna be very tactical, and it's gonna be very not campy-ish, but because that's what the whole game is geared for, is like being real covert and fucking sneaky and shit. That game, I actually looked up all the information that I could on Medal of Honor Warfighter. Medal of Honor Warfighter's online is going to look good because instead of it being just like the bad guy versus the good guys, it's going to be different countries' spec ops units against each other. So you're going to have Canada versus US versus Britain versus France versus Russia versus whoever. So, you know, whoever they stick in that bitch, and that shit looks awesome. That right there is going to be beast. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if it's going to be four versus four versus four, you know what I'm saying, via squad deathmatch on Battlefield 3. It's going to be using the DICE Engine 2, which is the Frostbite Engine 2, and looks pretty, what I've seen from it looks okay, you know what I'm saying? That, and it's going to be made by one company instead of it being split in half like it did, like, Danger Close and DICE doing the online on Medal of Honor. Well, it's just going to be Danger Close doing the online component and the campaign component, which is awesome because it doesn't fragment the game, doesn't give it a different look or a different sound or anything. It's all going to be one cohesive game, and that looks awesome. What else is games coming out? Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm Generations is coming out the 13th. And yes, I'm excited for this game. I'm a Naruto fan. I'm an anime fan. I love my cartoons. You can say whatever the hell you want to. Oh man, you're watching cartoons and blah, 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 blah. I'd rather watch cartoons than watch depressing ass fucking lies on the news and propaganda and the bullshit media. You know, if I want to fucking be depressed, you know, I could go to a damn, I could go to a homeless shelter and talk to people and stuff like that. Because the U.S. has as much problems as anybody else around the world. I'm getting off topic. Anyways, yeah, that game looks beast. It got, I think it's over 70 playable characters online battling it out. You know, you got the old generation versus new generation versus Kakashi when he was young versus my fucking the Hokages when they're old, and versus, you know, Madara Uchiha versus the Akatsuki versus, you know what I'm saying, Naruto when he was like 12, then he's like 18 or whatever the hell he is and shit. Oh, that's gonna be peace. Gonna be peace. Yes, I am looking forward to that motherfucking game. Yes, I am. Anyways, I just thought I'd just make this video. I'm gonna be a little bit busy today making some, trying to get some gameplay of some good video games that I got and try to put them out there. Remember, if y'all want to be, you know, my videos sent to your inbox, hit that subscribe button. It'll send your videos, it'll send the videos when I make the videos and upload them to your inbox. Thumbs up my video if you want to help my channel grow. I'd appreciate it, but it's not necessary. And if you don't subscribe, just check out my channel. You know what I'm saying? I put out a video most likely once every day at minimum. So that's it, pretty much. You know, I've been your commentator, your favorite average gamer, your host, Freddy Fuego, Flaming Hot Entertainment, MultiplatGameTrap.com, The People's Voice, your favorite, you know what I'm saying? Anyways, I want to repeat myself. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.
Thumb up the video, fool!